McLarty. You got shot at in front of your own home.
You know how these things happen. Some wild shots, some neighborhood punks, that's all.
Random act of violence.
Of course.
That just happened to be aimed at a Boston homicide lieutenant who just happened to be a witness in a murder
You're
case.
You're saying that was Sean Winston. The kid doesn't have the brains. I'm telling you that.
Maybe somebody else does. Maybe he's well connected. Maybe he's part of a protection racket.
Now back off, Frank, will you? If there is a case, I'll take care of it. I don't need you making up one for me. And next time, I'll pick the restaurant. Excuse me, Spenser. I've got to take care of my stomach.
You bet.
I knew he wasn't going to go for it.
Maybe he doesn't have your intestinal fortitude.
Come on, Spenser. I'm talking about the police protection.
Yeah, he wouldn't go for it, huh?
No. He says he's going to tough it out. It could have been anyone shooting at anyone. Didn't have anything to do with him.
Well, he's not dumb. I mean, if he thought he couldn't handle it, he'd pull you in.
Yeah. Well, just in case, I'm thinking there are times when you can get things done that we can't.
You want me to babysit him? You're that worried?
I guess I am.
I don't know. I'm a little particular about who I work for. So it'll have to be a freebie.
Thanks, Spenser. Hey, now, I don't want him to get wind of this.
No, I'll be quiet as a mouse.
Come on, let me buy you a dog.
No, thanks. I'm tough, but I'm not that tough.
Hey, no guts, no glory.
Like all top-notch detectives, I knew the most important thing to do before I started a long stakeout was to run my errands. You know, stock up on food, have plenty of clean clothes, because shadowing somebody like Marty wouldn't be a 9-to-5 job. Come to think of it, I sure wouldn't mind having some help.
Well, a friend in need is a friend indeed. How about give me a hand here?
Clothes finally where they belong. Besides, I come to put you into some long green where you can buy yourself a whole brand new set of double knits.
Well, I'm a little busy at the moment, if you hadn't noticed.
Not too busy for this day. The last of the wealthy Texas oil barons are having a convention in Dallas, and they need the services of some professional security guard gentlemen, for which they are paying professional rates $1,000 a day.
Why are you still here telling me about it?
They say it's a two-man gig.
Oh, so you're inviting me?
You always jump into my mind, babe. Besides, the big payoff comes in the night when these gentlemen gather around the table for a serious poker game. A game which I know we can get ourselves into because you and me be very seriously good at poker.
Yes, this is true. Also very enticing. Unfortunately, I got a gig of my own.
Huh?
Somebody took a shot at Marty Quirk. Belson figures whoever did might try again. As a matter of fact, I could use your help.
I know the name of this tango, but you're going to have to dance it alone this time, babe. I cannot possibly conceive of me giving up this good quantity of money to protect the man.
We're not talking about the man. We're talking about Marty Quirk.
No. You ain't going to even make bad money for this. No.
I've never worn double knit in my life.
No!